ओके सर,
गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव मिस्टर रवि कुमार विथ अस. ही विल बी हैंडलिंग टुडे बैलेंस शीट एनालिसिस. ओवर टू मिस्टर रवि कुमार सर. सर यू कैन स्टार्ट.
ओके, गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स. द बैलेंस शीट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू इकोनॉमिक पर्पस आल्सो. व्हेन यू आर वर्किंग इन ब्रांचेस यू हैव टू डू बैलेंस शीट एनालिसिस. सो आई ट्राई टू इन दिस क्लास आई विल ट्राई टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द बैलेंस शीट इज ड्रॉन. So that if you understand how the balance sheet is drawn, you can answer any question examiner asks. Maybe it will take some time today because I will explain balance sheet concept first. Then I will explain how the problems to be solved in the examination. I will take care of NWC, current ratio, debt equity ratio, even DSCR also. Here only problems always comes in the exam. They never ask more than that. If you want to prepare, you can prepare. If a tough questions, if you require, I have to take another class. Now I am taking a basic class where you will understand balance sheet and whatever problem let him give, I will make you easy to answer those questions. This is how I prepared my balance sheet class and problem. Sir. Okay. Okay, my side. Huh?
Yeah.
If I my. I have pressed that button record. Let me see, sir. Any display will come to me that it is recording?
On the top, you have a recording.
No, it is not coming. Your screen sharing recording, I pressed that button. Okay, it is going, I think. It's showing stop recording. Okay, sir. That annotations I have to delete, I think. Somebody is doing.
Yeah, that's
true. Disable annotations for others, na?
Yeah, that's
true. Okay, sir, I have done it. Okay, friends, we will start the class today, balance sheet analysis. Generally, anybody, if they want to start a business, even after retirement, we want to start a business, we need a balance sheet which to be submitted to the bank, right? Then only bank will finance us. Generally, bank provides term loan and working capital for MSME customers, right? Please remember, term loan will be sanctioned only for fixed assets. Please remember this important point I'm telling you. Term loan, we should always give for term fixed assets only. What are the fixed assets? Maybe plant and machinery, maybe land and building, maybe computers, which are all fixed in nature. That finance will be done in the form of term loan. Coming to second point, OCC. OCC, we generally give for only one purpose, to purchase of stock. If he's a trader, we will give it for only stock. If he's a manufacturer, we give it for purchase of raw material, processing, and finished goods preservation, and then he will sell. While selling, he may sell it for book debts also. Book debts is nothing but whatever limit you have given, based on that, whatever stock he brought or manufactured the stock, that will be sold to any customer in cash means no problem. He will get realized. If he gives credit, okay, I am selling this stock, you pay me after 1 month. That is called book debts. That is book debts, or we call it as bills receivable. Please remember, book debts, bills receivable, all are same. Okay. And one more thing which I want to tell you here for your academic interest. Generally, what people will do, they will give term loan for stocks. This is a wrong thing which we are doing. Term loan, we cannot give for stocks. RBI guidelines are very clear. For always stocks, we should give OCC. If you are giving term loan, I will tell you why people will give term loan also. The customer says, sir, if I take OCC for 5 lakhs and if I purchase stock, lifelong my loan account will not be closed because I will pay interest, I will do transactions, that 5 lakhs will be there lifelong. If you give a term loan for 5 lakhs, every month I will pay you 20,000, 10,000, something interest and principal. By after 4 or 5 years, that loan will be closed. Same principle bank also follows with you. Na? Bank. They never give more amount in clean OD. They give DPN. Why they give DPN? Because it's a term loan. You will pay from your salary every month. Automatically, it will deduct. And after 5 years, minimum without your knowledge and without your, of course, you will have a pain of that. After your pain, ultimately after 5 years, that loan will be closed. Your liability will be zero. Again, you can take a DPN. Like that, customer also will say, sir, don't give OCC. And managers also very much interested to give term loan for purchase of stock. Friends, this is not correct. Why? I will tell you. Why manager will give term loan also, I will tell you. If you giving OCC for stocks, you have to take stock statement. Every year you have to renew. Term loan means no renewal, no stock statement, no DP. Only once you give the loan of 4-5 lakhs, every month he will pay the amount and automatically loan will be closed after 4-5 years. Stock statement, dormancy, out of order, no issues. Only you have to take installment. This is the reason our managers are interested. Customer is interested because one day the loan will be closed. These are two mutual parties are happy. Then generally they will compromise and they will give term loan. But as per guidelines, you should not give term loan for purchase of stocks. Why I am telling is, in RBIA, many inspectors write this, and after that, we are facing trouble because we cannot give. So we have to close that term loan again and we have to give OCC. So I request you, please avoid this type of finance. So if you're 10,000, 20,000 or 50,000, okay. But lakhs, if you are giving, you will be in trouble. So this is what term loan means for fixed assets. Working capital means for purchase of stock. For a trader means only stock will be there. If he's a manufacturer, he will have so many things. Now we are coming to, before we are approaching a bank, we must analyze what amount we require for fixed assets or stock or whatever it may be, raw material, finished goods. How much we want, first we have to analyze. Borrower will analyze. Now we are thinking in borrower angle. Please remember, I am not talking on bank angle. As a borrower, we need some finance. We have decided to start one manufacturing unit, one bottle manufacturing unit. So we have to construct a building for my business, for our business. We are businessmen now. We are not bankers. Think that we are the businessmen. So I need a land and building. I need a plant and machinery. I told you, for land and building and plant and machinery, bank always give term loan. How to know how much land and building investment is required? Estimation. You take a civil engineer estimation, how much required for this land and building. He will give some 40 lakhs, 2 crore. Based on your investment, based on your business, he will give how much it will. That is called land and building amount, which you are going to incur in that particular business. Coming to plant and machinery. After construction, you keep plant and machinery for processing. So what is the plant and machinery? For plant and machinery, you will go to some two, three businesses. You see same type of business. You see which machinery is good and all. You will do some survey. And after that, you will take a quotation from one particular company to purchase this plant and machinery. This quotation will tell you what is the value of plant and machinery you are going to invest. So land and building over, plant and machinery over. Now construction is over, machinery has come. Then what we will do, sir? Then we will start working on that unit. For these are all fixed assets and these are all variable. Now we will purchase raw material. Without putting raw material, plant and machinery is useless. So we purchase raw material, then we will process, work in progress we do, that raw material will be processed and a finished goods water bottle will be prepared. This is called stock. All the three will be called as stock. If you want to differentiate, it is raw material, it is work in progress, it is finished goods. If you, once the finished goods is over, if you are selling it on cash, no problem. If you are giving on credit to somebody for 30 days, 60 days, that name is called as book debts. That means you have given credit to somebody. Okay. This is how we have prepared our balance sheet. Now we have finalized what exactly we want. Now you see, the land and building estimator has given 40 lakhs. Plant and machinery, I got a quotation for 40 lakhs. So I'm 80 lakhs, I require term loan. Raw material, work in progress, finished goods, I have arrived. Book debts, I want to give 40 lakhs. 48 total is here. 80 lakhs term loan I want for this purpose. And I require 120 for raw material, work in progress. This is called running activity. For running the activity, every time I require, please remember, this is once you have done, why this is called term loan, why we are giving is land and building, plant and machinery, once only we invest. But here it is not like that. It's a running expenditure. That's why running account is required. That's why we are giving OCC. Okay. So we cannot give term loan to them. We cannot give OCC to them. This is what we have to remember. Okay. And expenditure, we have already, whatever investment we want to make, it is finalized. 80 lakhs for these purposes and 120 lakhs for these purposes. Okay. Now we will approach bank. Now we approach bank and ask for assistance. Generally, what bank will tell, as a branch managers, they will tell, sir, we require 25% margin, 75% only we finance. These margin may differ from scheme to scheme, please remember this important point, scheme to scheme margin may differ. Okay, now we have approached bank, asked to put margin from our angle. So this is our assets we want to create. Out of this, we will tell the bank, told this is 80 lakhs you want term loan, na? Bring 25%. Out of 80 lakhs, 25% is 20 lakhs, right? Purchase of fixed assets, bank is asking 20 lakhs to keep my amount. This is my margin which I have to bring to purchase this 80 lakhs. Coming to stock, this stock and all, 120 it came total. Running expenditure, 120. For that 120, again bank asked me 25% margin. How much it will be? 25% of 120 is 30 lakhs. That means total assets which I want to create is 200 lakhs. Out of that, 25% bank is asking me to bring margin. That means 120 plus, 25 plus 30, 20 plus 30, 50 lakhs I should bring margin. It is nothing but out of 200, 25% is 50 lakhs. If I bring 50 lakhs to you, bank is telling I will finance 150 lakhs to you. Correct? This is what the banker, bank manager concept. Now you see. Same thing, 80 lakhs, 120. These are called assets. We are creating assets with our capital and bank loan. These are all the assets. Okay? Fixed assets, land and building and plant and machinery, raw material, work in progress, finished good, book debts will be called as current asset. I will tell you why it is called as current asset in my next slides. So fixed assets. Now, bank, what the bank told? Says 200. You please bring margin. How much? You see, out of 80, 25% is 20 lakhs. This margin I kept here. And for working, out of 120, 30 lakhs I will bring. Here I have kept my margin. Remaining 90 bank OCC they will give. So out of these 80 lakhs, I should bring 25%. That is 20 lakhs. This margin I kept here. Margin will be called as capital. Please remember, whatever you are bringing into the business for purchase of fixed assets and current asset is called margin. Technically, it will be called as capital. That's all. Nothing but capital is nothing but your share in investment in these fixed assets. Bank told 25%. Total 200, it is 50. But if you bifurcate into fixed assets and current assets, 20 and 30, total 50. For purchasing of fixed asset, if they want 80 lakhs, 20 lakhs if you bring margin, how much bank will finance term loan, sir? 60 lakhs, right? 80 minus 20 you brought, 25%, 60 lakhs. This is what 60 lakhs. Current assets are running material, 120 they require. Bank told me to bring 25 lakhs. I brought 30. Remaining 120 minus 30 is 90. That will be financed in the form of bank OCC. Okay. Now we see the balance sheet. Now you see the balance sheet. Fixed assets 80, current assets 120, total assets I want to purchase 200 to start my business. For that, bank asked me to bring 25% margin. Yes, I brought 25% margin, 50 lakhs out of the 200. But if you want to segregate that margin for fixed assets and current assets, 80, 25% is 20, 120 ka 25% is 30, total 50 lakhs I will keep here as my capital. Then I will tell the bank, for your 200 assets which I proposed you for finance, I brought 50 lakhs which you told me to bring 25%. Now you give me finance. Now what bank will do? Out of 80, again I am telling, 20 they will minus and remaining 60 they will finance under term loan for purchase of fixed assets. For current assets, 120 we have asked, we brought 30 lakhs as per bank request, 25%. Remaining they will finance under OCC. Now the balance sheet is telling, 80 plus 120 is 200. 50 we brought the margin as a businessman. Remaining bank is ready to finance. Term loan 60, bank OCC 90, total 200. This is called a balance sheet. Now we will understand the names. Now balance sheet is tallied. Preparation is over. Now we will give some technical names. People will tell a long-term source, long-term use. Now we will try to understand. In the examination, I don't know how he is going to pose the question. The first thing which I want to tell you is, one good name I want to tell you. What is a source and what is a use? First, you understand this. Whatever amount you are taking from bank and using for creating the assets is called uses. That means these are all uses. You are taking loan, you are bringing your capital. With that, you are purchasing some assets, fixed assets, current assets, whatever it may be. You are purchasing. So assets are always called as use. Why use? We are using money and purchasing these assets or creating these assets. That's why it is called as use. Liabilities, capital I brought, bank has given some loans. This is called as source. Why we call it as source? Because to start this business, we need some money. Something we brought, something we took loan from bank. That is the reason all these liabilities called as sources. For a businessman, whatever loans he is taking is a source for him. Wherever he is investing, it will be called as use. So liabilities will be called as source. Assets will be called as use. I told you why it is use, why it is a source. This is a finance. You are getting finance. Source, funds are coming. How funds are coming? By capital I brought, some term loan bank has given, some OCC bank has given. So this is a source. And with this source, I am using this money by for creating assets. That is the reason it will be called as assets. Now, one more name I want to give you. Out of this source and use, now you are clear. What is source? What is use? Now I want to tell you what is a long-term use, and out of this use only we see. What is a long-term use? What is a short-term use? See, if you are using these assets for a longer period, it is called as long-term use. See, for example, land and building you have purchased. You have created asset, land and building, plant and machinery. These things will be there for more than 5 to 10 years. Long usage we are doing. That is the reason fixed assets will be called as long-term use. And raw material, work in progress, very fastly this will be converted. Raw material, within 2-3 days, it will be converted to work in progress. Then by finished goods, it will be converted. Again, we will sell it for cash, or sometimes we sell it for book debts. So that means this conversion is very fast. So the usage of money, what we have taken from sources, here we are using for long term, here we are using for short term. So all these items which are used for small, shorter period, we call it as short term use. For a longer period, if you are using this amount for creating assets, that is called long term use. So assets will be called as uses, and even that assets which are created in long term in nature, that will be called as long term use. Example, land and building and plant and machinery. These are all will be for short period we use. Even though we purchase this, it is usually for longer. Immediately it will be converted to cash very fastly. That's why we call it as short-term use. Okay. Coming to sources. Here also we have to bifurcate long-term source and short-term source. There are only 3 sources. One is capital, another is term loan, another is your bank OCC. 3 sources I told you. Technically, we should remember these 3 important things. Capital, till the business is there, your capital will be there. You cannot take out your capital generally. So that is the reason capital will be a long-term source. Term loan, when fixed assets are created for longer period, whatever loan you are taking, that also will be longer period. Na? That is the reason term loan will be given for 5 years, 7 years, 10 years. It is a long-term source. You will not repay within 1 year. It is a long-term source. So capital and term loan are long-term sources, and short-term sources will be your bank OCC. Bank OCC, how much period we will give? Only 1 year. After 1 year, account will be renewed. That is the reason it will be called as short-term source. Okay. Now I will tell you what is current asset and current liability. Now you understood usage and sources, long-term use, short-term use, long-term source, short-term source. One more word I want to add you, that is current assets and current liabilities. This is a very important terminology you should understand. See, these are assets. Don't confuse. These are assets. Out of that asset, any asset, if it is converted into cash within 12 months, that is called as current asset. Land and building, first we will see. Whether it will be converted to cash in 12 months? No. 5 years, 10 years, it will be there. So it is not a current asset. It is a fixed asset. Plant and machinery, whether it will be converted to cash within 12 months? No. So it is a long-term use or fixed asset. Over. Now we will see raw material. Whether raw material will be converted into cash within 12 months? 100%. Otherwise, that business cannot run. So raw material is a current asset. Work in progress. After raw material will convert to work, how many days you will work in progress? You will do 10 days, 15 days, 1 month. That's all. So work in progress also will be converted within 12 months to cash. So that is also a current asset. Coming to finished goods. Once goods are prepared, how many days the businessman will keep the business? Whether he will keep for more than 1 year, he will not sell the stock. No, no chance. If he is keeping for 1 year, means his useless business is doing. So finished goods also will be converted to cash less than 1 year. It is a 12 months is a very longer period. How much period you will take? More than 1 month or 2 months, automatically finished goods will be converted. Book debts. How much period you will give book debts credit? Whether you will give for 1 year, then you are not a good businessman. So book debts can be given maximum up to 90 days only, generally. If you are giving any credit to anybody, he should get back your money within 90 days. That means book debts, the stock which is converted, you have sold on credit, will be converted to cash maximum within 90 days. But time permitted is 12 months. So converting to cash within 90 days. So that is also current asset. You should understand the logic why this is called as current assets. Any asset converted to cash within 12 months will be called as current assets. That is the reason all these items will be called as current assets. I hope I am clear with fixed assets and current assets. Current assets are also called as short-term use, right? Because 12 months only, usage is shorter period. Now we will come here. Now here is current liabilities we call. This is short-term source as we thought. Why current liabilities? Anything you are taking source, if you are paying within 12 months, that is called as current liability. Simple. This 12 months is very important. In the examination, he may ask, current asset definition, he may ask. Current assets means what? Converting into cash within 12 months. Current liability means any liability I have taken, if I repay within 12 months, that is called as current liability. Another name of current liability is short-term sources. Okay, bank OCC. Now we see the items. Fixed assets, whether are you going to pay within 12 months, sir? No. Capital, are you paying? No. Capital will be there till my business runs. And term loan, if you are taking, whether term loan, are you going to pay within 1 year? No. More than 5 years. That is the reason term loan definition always says 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. So you are not going to repay within 1 year. Okay. So that is the reason this can't be a current, your current liability. So what can be current liability? Bank OCC also you are taking. That OCC you will pay within 12 months. That is the reason this is a current liability. Creditors, here you are giving. You are giving credit. Creditor means you are taking credit for stock. This is also one source. You want for stock of 100 lakhs stock. Bank is giving 80 lakhs. 20 lakhs you can take on credit. Na? Somebody will tell, sir, you take raw material from me, I will provide you. He is a creditor. We have to pay the amount. How you are giving credit, you can also get credit from somebody. That person will be called as creditor. And creditor, and one more word we use is payable. We have to pay, we have to make the payment to him. That is the reason bills payable word also they use instead of creditor. Here they will call book debts, and another word I told is bills receivable. We have to receive the amount. Bills receivable, book debts are same. Bills payable and creditors are one and the same. I hope this is a typical balance sheet for a proprietorship or a partnership account. Other than this, generally you don't find in current liabilities, any liabilities are there, provisions are there, that also will come under current liability. Because any provisions if you are making, within 12 months you are going to pay. That is the reason provisions also will be qualified for current liability. Now let me tell you what is net working capital. We will say net working capital, net working capital. Always we say current assets minus current liabilities is net working capital. We should not read anything like this. We should understand what is net working capital. See, you made short-term usage. Now balance sheet you understood in the previous slide. These are your short-term current assets. How much you wanted? 120. This is your current assets you want from the bank to run your business. These are all called current assets. What bank has given current liability? You got 80 lakhs OCC for that, and the creditors are 10 lakhs. Total 90 lakhs. You want 120 lakhs. But what bank told in the earlier stage, they asked you to bring 25% margin, right? Where is the 25%, sir? it is in the capital. You brought your margin in the form of capital. That is the reason it is available at capital. So 120 you want, 30 you brought in the capital, remaining 90 you got finance. How you got 90 lakhs? Bank has given 80 lakhs. Somebody as creditor has given you 90 lakhs. So if you entire current assets, total assets, current assets minus your current liabilities, that means your financiers, bank, creditors, if you minus, what will come? The investment you made in the current assets, you will get. That is called net working capital. In another way, I will tell you, net working capital means for purchase of current assets, whatever finance I am getting, if I deduct this finance, my margin will come. That is nothing but net working capital. Or you can say, for purchase of current assets, whatever margin I brought into the business is called as net working capital. Net working capital means, that is the reason the simply people will say, you do total current assets and minus current liability, you will get your NWC. Okay. Now you see how bank will calculate NWC. They total current assets first. All these current assets they will tot. Raw material, work in progress, finished goods, book debts. Okay. Minus these current liabilities they deduct. Bank, OCC, creditors. Then they will get NWC. In simple terms, we can say borrower money sir, don't request, sir. You can regain command. Tripurari, sir, why you are requesting, sir? Okay. NWC means, in simple terms, borrower money brought in for purchase of these current assets. So total current assets we have taken 120. Total current liabilities we have taken 120. NWC is 30 lakhs. So this is 30 lakhs, which you have brought as a margin, if you remember. Okay, 25% you brought. To find out this 30 lakhs, the formula is total current assets minus current liabilities. So net working capital means current assets minus current liabilities, 120 minus 30. And one more thing, like one more way we can call is, current assets other name is short term use. Current liabilities other name is short term source. So short term use minus short term source also, we can call it as net working capital. This is short term use. This is short term use minus short term source. Name is same, that's all. Okay. Now one more way, how to find out net working capital, I will tell you. Because sometimes 3 to 4, they will ask this type of question. We should know. See, the easy formula is current assets minus current liabilities. You know pretty well. One more formula is there. That is called long-term use source minus long-term use. See, these are the long-term source. Long-term source is this. Capital and your margin. What is your margin? 50 is your capital. And total term loans, you have sanctioned 60 lakhs. Okay. Total is 110. Fixed assets, how much you have purchased? 80. 40 for land and building, plant and machinery, 40. 80 lakhs. Okay. Now you take total long-term source. Long-term source means capital and term loan. Correct? With a longer period, I told you. 50 plus 60, 110. Use is 80. 110 minus 80. See, this 30 lakhs has come. How this 30 lakhs has come? Many people doesn't know this formula. Everybody knows NWC means current assets minus current liability. Please understand the logic. This is a term loan amount, 60 lakhs. You want actually 80 lakhs term loan, right? But what bank told you? Bring 25% margin. You brought fixed assets margin 20 lakhs. Remaining 60 lakhs, they are financed. These 60 plus 20 will become this 80. But in capital, you brought working capital margin also here. This is extra available here. Please remember, this is extra available. With this only, they have purchased these current assets on the bottom of the balance sheet. So that is the reason when you are totaling capital, this current asset margin also available here. It is not 20 plus 60, it is 50. If fixed asset margin is available in current asset, it might have been tallied. Because you brought current asset margin also and keep in capital, the capital is more. How much more? Current asset margin is more. So that is the reason from 50 plus 60, if you add and if you deduct these 80, you will get NWC. There are two formulas for NWC. One is straight method, current assets minus current liabilities. Another method is long-term source minus long-term use. I will quote one more example. You will understand better. Now you see. Now entire balance sheet I am showing you. These are the assets you have purchased. 200. Bank told us to bring margin. I brought 50 lakhs margin. 60 lakhs they have given term loan. And 90 lakhs bank OCC they have given 90. Now you see. What is the first NWC formula? Total current assets 120. Total current liabilities 90. 120 minus 30. Where this 30 has come, sir? From these 50 lakhs, the margin is available here. That is the reason you got this 30. Out of this 50, 30 was coming here to 30 plus this 90 purchased these assets. So if you want 30 here, you just 120 minus 90 you do, you will get these 30 lakhs from capital. Okay. Now coming to long-term source, you see 50 plus 60, 110. This is long-term source. Here also 30 lakhs is available. Your margin, which you want to purchase current assets, you brought here and kept. So these 50 and 60 is 110 minus fixed assets 80 will give you again NWC. That is the reason to generate NWC, you have two formulas. Okay. Now let me tell you what is current ratio. In the examination, I don't know how he is going to question. Sometimes directly he will ask current ratio. Sometimes they will ask ticklingly, what is current ratio? Why you calculate current ratio? So we must understand the concept why we calculate current ratio. What is current ratio? In simple layman language, I will tell you current assets, how much current assets a firm is having. These are all your purchased assets, right? Uses, your purchase. How much current assets a firm is having to clear the current liabilities? You have taken bank loan, you have taken creditors loan, all these loans you have taken to purchase these current assets, right? If even any eventuality happens, suddenly your business ruined down, you want to close the business, what will happen, sir? I will sell all your current assets and clear bank loan first. So bank always sees, if I am giving 1 rupee loan, how much current assets he is creating. This is called current ratio. That is the reason current ratio formula is total current assets divided by total current liabilities. Total current assets minus total current divided by current liabilities. If you make, you will get current ratio. Okay. Now you see, this is one balance sheet. Now we will see how the current ratio can be calculated. Current ratio means current assets minus current liabilities. Current assets are there, current liabilities they will give. Let us calculate current asset. You see in this balance sheet, where are the current assets? These are all long-term assets, fixed assets. These are the current assets. Raw material, work in progress, finished goods, book debts. You must know what is a current asset also. Sometimes they will not give you directly current assets. They will give some assets and they will ask you to calculate current ratio. So you must know in the asset side, some assets will be there which are converted very fastly, will be called as, within 12 months will be called as current asset. Okay. Now you see total current assets will be, calculation of current assets means raw material, work in progress, finished goods, book debts, 20, 20, 40, 40. So total is 120. These are current assets in your balance sheet. Now coming to current liabilities. These are the assets you have created. Now you see how much current liabilities you have taken to create these current assets. You have taken bank OCC. You have taken some creditors. So total is 90, 80 plus 90. Total 90 lakhs is current liability. Therefore, now we can calculate current ratio. Total current assets are 120. Current liabilities are 90. 120 divided by 90. The formula will come 1.33. What is meant by this 1.33, sir? The ratio is telling what it is defining. Current ratio 1.33 means, how to understand is, 1 rupee loan we have taken, and assets we have created 1.33. It is a very good proposition for the bank. If it is 1.33 means 1 rupee 33 paisa assets are available to clear 1 rupee of current liabilities, bank feel comfortable. If it comes 1.25, bank feels comfortable. If it is 1, current assets also 1, current liabilities also 1. It is very equal. So you see, if I keep the margin, based on the margin only this ratio is improving. See, here bank told me to bring 25% margin. So out of 120, I brought 30 lakhs. Remaining 90 bank has given. That is the reason 120 by 90, if I have done, I got this 1.33 ratio. If bank might have told me to bring 50% margin, Ravi Kumar, you want 120 for current assets, you bring 50%. So 60 lakhs only bank will give loan. So remaining 60, I should brought. Then the ratio will improve to 120 minus 62. Current ratio 2 means for any eventuality comes, current assets are 2 rupees, current liability only 1 rupee. Very aram, so you can clear the liability. Okay. That means current ratio, if it is more, you are more, bank feels more comfortable because party is having more assets. If any eventuality comes, we can sell the assets or we can sell the assets and we can clear the liability of current liability. If current liability is 120, margin is nil, current assets also same. Current assets 120, current liability is also 120. In this case, what happens? Current ratio will become 1. What is meant by 1, sir? Current assets also barabar. Dono very much equal. 1:1. That means 1 rupee you have given, 1 rupee only stock is available. No margin is available from the party. Please remember. Okay. If negative, sir, current assets are 100, liabilities are 120. That means something is wrong. You have financed 120 rupees and assets are only 100. When you share this current ratio, 100, current assets are 100, current liabilities are 120. 100 minus 120, it will come less than 1, 0.83. What does it mean? If it is less than 1 means whatever loan you have given, even that much of stock is not available in the unit. This is how you have to understand current ratio. Okay, current ratio is over. TUL, TNW, they never asked any question. But anyway, I will tell you what is TUL by TNW for your academic purpose also. Total loans, whatever loans BAP customer is taking, divided by tangible net worth will give you TOL by TNW. Total outside liabilities. Where the borrower has taken outside loans, sir? He has taken bank OCC. He has taken term loan. He has taken creditors. All current liabilities. He has to pay back. So those are all called total loans. What is net worth, sir? Total capital he brought into the business is called generally net worth. For a proprietorship account or a partnership account, it will be called as whatever capital he brought. If it is a company, capital plus free reserves will be calculated as a net worth. But please remember, when you are company account, when you are doing, if you want tangible net worth, you have to deduct capital plus reserves minus intangible assets. Intangible assets means booked patent rights, goodwill, all these things you have to deduct. These are fictitious in nature. Total capital, you have to, these are on the asset side, you have to minus, then only you will arrive tangible net worth for companies. Now let us see TOL TNW. Bank asks you to bring 25% margin. Therefore, loan, how much it will be, sir? 75% you can take advance. So 75% bank loan, 25% margin. So 25% is his net worth. That means 75% he is taking burden. The ratio will become 3:1. If 25% margin you are bringing, if bank is giving 75%, formula is total outside liabilities will be 75, net worth will be 25. 75 by 25 will become 3. 3:1 means 3 times he is taking finance, 1 time he brought margin. Okay. Example 2. If bank says, please bring 20% margin. Now you see how TOL TNW will deteriorate. Bank will give 80% loan. So 20% I will bring, 80% bank will finance. So 80% will be my burden. 20% is my net worth. 80 by 20, 4:1. If you observe, if you are reducing margin, your TOL TNW will increase. That means parties net worth to total loans we are comparing. If it is becoming more, his share is less, bank loan is more. This is what you have to understand from TOL by TNW. Now you see one more balance sheet from for TOL TNW. And now you see TOL TNW means I told you total outside liabilities. What are the total outside liabilities he borrowed, sir? These are the liabilities. What are the outside liabilities? Capital is his money, his own money, his net worth it is. So term loan he took 60, bank OCC and all he took 90. 90 plus 60 is his burden, his loans, total outside liabilities. Let's calculate 60 plus 90, 150. This is his total outside liabilities. Coming to net worth, capital is his net worth. If it is a proprietorship firm or a partnership firm, tangible net worth. There is no intangible assets because it is not a company account. That's why we are not deducting any intangible assets. If there are intangible assets, please remember for calculating net worth, total capital, if any reserves are there, that also we will add. Then it will become net worth. From that net worth, you have to deduct intangible assets. These intangible assets word we will use in company balance sheet only. Now, 50 minus 0, intangible assets are not there. So total tangible net worth will be 50. Now TOL TNW formula we will adopt. Total outside liabilities are 150. And total net worth is 50 capital. 150 minus 50 is 3. So ratio is 3:1. TOL TNW 3:1 means 25% borrower brought, 75% we have financed. This is what this formula we should understand. Now, current ratio, our bank, what it says, for important purpose, I will tell you. See, turnover method, assessment of limits, you should learn. Then only you will understand. For now, promotion exam, promotion purpose, we will understand. If you are calculating under turnover method, bank says 20% margin we have to bring borrower. So that is the reason turnover method, the benchmark current ratio will be 1.25. If you are calculating under MPBF method, the benchmark will be 1.33. Why 1.33? Because in MPBF, the margin is 25%. You have to bring remaining 75% bank will finance. Please remember these two important ratios. They will ask, what is the benchmark for turnover method? 1.25 current ratio benchmark. What is the current ratio benchmark under turnover method? 1.33. Okay. These two are available in your credit policy also. Maybe Chandrasekhar Reddy sir might have covered. If current ratio shall not be less than 1.25, 1.33, depending on the quantum and loan. Generally, we will allow 1.25, 1.33 only. But please remember, our bank policy says current ratio up to 1 can be permitted by respective sanctioning authority. As a branch manager, if you want to sanction a loan, a OCC loan or something, OCC, current ratio is current assets minus current liability. For OCC only, we see that ratio. If it is 1, both are equal. Current assets, current liability, 1:1. Risk is there. But till 1, bank told, as a branch manager, you go ahead. No problem. But you have to justify it. Please remember. Existing borrower accounts. Sir, renewal party has come. Then what to do? Who can permit if it is less than 1? GM, COC and above authorities can permit renewal, enhancement, additional. GM is the topmost authority in the circle. So they have given, even though it is less than 1, the GM can permit any account with justification. Even GM sir is permitting also, he will justify why current ratio is less than 1. GM, COC and below authorities, they cannot permit. Please remember, less than 1 means they cannot permit. Then who has to permit? Your next higher authority has to permit. Can permit renewal and enhancement. If it is a renewal or you are doing some enhancement in the account, even below authorities also empowered. You can do it. Because fresh loan you cannot do. First time if it is less than 1 means there is a trouble in the balance sheet. Trouble in the assessment. So that is the reason they have not allowed you. But renewal in enhancement, okay, you can go ahead. But if you want to give any additional, some other finance he wants, you cannot permit. You have to take clearance from next higher authority. If current ratio is less than 1 and during the renewal time or sometime, if he's asking additional finance, but renewal, even it is less than 1 also, you are allowed. You are being allowed to permit. new borrowable accounts, if the current ratio is less than one, generally not to be entertained. Who is anybody is having power? See, he is coming for loan first time and he is telling, I will keep current assets as 1 rupee and liabilities as 1 rupee. Who will permit you, boss? It should be 1.25. Your assets should be more. How can I permit? You are coming, just now you are entering the bank. You are a new customer to me. So that is the reason bank says very clearly, if CR is less than one, up to one, okay. It is a worst condition, but okay, we are permitted. But less than one is worst condition. Current assets are all not able to cover your current liabilities. That is less than one. Generally not to be entertained for new customer, but only in exceptional cases, GM, HO, CAC is having powers. But if it is justified, then he may permit, okay? So TOL, TNW benchmark, if you want to know, up to 4:1, as a branch manager, you can permit. 4:1 means 20% party will bring as net worth and 80% you can finance. Then you can permit. Otherwise, that you can permit. You cannot. Relaxation can be permitted. This is a credit policy also. This point is with regard to credit policy also. For a manufacturing unit, up to 6:1, you can permit. For trading units, up to 9:1, you can permit. Please remember, these relaxations, the 6:1, 9:1, can be permitted always with due justification. Why 6:1 you want to permit? Why 9:1? Up to 4:1, okay. 20% is having net worth and 80% I am financing. Bank is convinced. If it is going deteriorated, you have to justify why you want to finance, okay? And only by next higher authorities only they can do. For a fresh advance, only next higher authorities only can do. As a branch manager, you cannot do if TOL, TNW is above 4:1, okay? But renewal, you can do it, no problem. GM always permitted to, even if it is 6:1, 9:1, even for a new account also, GMs, CGMs are permitted. But renewal time, respect, even you can also permit 6:1, 9:1, no problem. This is with regard to TOL by TNW, okay? These two are very important ratios when you are doing working capital assessment. That's why it took a little bit time. I linked with credit policy. What ratio you can accept? Now you know what is TOL, TNW. Now you should understand to what extent you can permit. My balance sheet class is over. Now company balance sheet, I am going to show you to make you understand a little bit better. I told you liability side capital will come. Entire capital reserves. No confusion. Same thing I told. Term liabilities. Generally term loan I told. But companies, if you are financing, debentures will come. But please remember, anything more than 1 year only, debentures also, not maturing 1 year only, we can call as term liability. If it is less than 1 year, debenture, it should come as current liability. Please remember. So amount, term liability, current liability, if you want to bifurcate, you have to see within how much period you are going to repay. If you are repaying within 1 year, it is a current liability. If you are repaying more than 1 year, it is a term liability. Term loan, we never pay within 1 year. That is the reason this is a term liability. Debentures, if you are paying maturing within 1 year, you have to pay the amount. That is a term liability. Not maturing 1 year is a term liability. Maturing within a year, the deposits, debentures, installments of term loan, anything payable within 1 year is a current liability. Not only bank OCC, creditor, provisions, any liability, if you are paying within 1 year, it is a current liability. So whenever any liability, if you want to bifurcate a term liability or current liability, you should understand in how much period you are going to pay back that amount. Okay. So debentures will be term liability, term loans, 100% time liability, deposits, borrowings. If any borrowings you made, it is a source, you brought some borrowings. If it is payable beyond 1 year, it is a term liability. Any deposits, borrowings you made and you are paying within 1 year, it is a current liability. Okay. Now you see what are the current liabilities. Short-term bank borrowing, that is means bank OCC, working capitals from others. Any unsecured loan, if you are taking from anybody like this, that is called as, generally we call it current liability. But if this unsecured also, if it is paid more than 1 year, it is a term liability. You can go here. Unsecured loans also, you cannot straight away say it's a current liability. You have to see the payment. If unsecured loan, borrower is going, our borrower is paying within 1 year, this is current liability. If it is more than 1 year, it is term liability. sundry creditors. I told you, you have taken some credit from somebody, you will pay within 1 year only. Within 30, 40 days, you have to pay back. Advance payment. If any advance payment you have received, it is a source for you. Source means liability. So that also will be advance payment received from customers, dealers. Being a businessman, if you are getting any advance payments from your borrowers, that also is a current liability because you have to pay within 1 year. Any deposits, debentures, I already told you. Any other provisions, liabilities due within 1 year, some provision you made, some electricity bill you have to pay, some disputes are there. If you want to pay within 1 year, this is current liability. So liabilities are classified into three. One is capital, another is term liabilities, another is current liability. Capital, you are very clear. Capital and reserves only, nothing. Okay. Term liabilities means term loans will come, or debentures or any deposits. If it is paid more than 1 year, if you are not paying within 1 year, it is called term liability. Any liabilities coming here, bank OCC creditors provisions, normally we see. Other than that, any amount you are receiving as a source, if you are paying within 1 year, that is called current liability. I hope these three things are very clear for you with regard to liability. Coming to asset side, fixed assets, I already told you, anything is fixed, repayment more than 1 year, if you are making, these term loans will be given for these fixed assets. Land and building, plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures, vehicles, computers, all are fixed assets only. These are all asset side fixed assets. Let me tell you first what is current assets. Fixed assets, after I will go to current assets. Inventory, stock, I told you, raw material, work in progress, finished goods, stock, everything is current assets. Then sundry debtors, I told you, if you are giving credit, it will be called as debtor. Debtor's other name is bills receivable. I should receive the amount. Here I am paying. This here we can call bills payable. Here, receivable. Okay. Cash and bank balance, current assets, already high liquidity. What 12 months? Already in cash only. So converting into 12 months cash is a current asset. Cash itself is already in your account. 1 day also not required. Bank balance, it is in your account. It is a current asset. Please remember, people will have a doubt. Fixed deposits, especially. Sir, fixed deposits, if it is within 1 year, I will take current asset. If it is more than 1 year, I will take non-current asset. No. Bank has given in the manual very clearly, fixed deposits, government securities, and quoted investments, we can straight away classify under current assets. There is a logic behind that. Maybe a FD you made for 5 years. That means this is liquidated not within 1 year. It will be liquidated within 5 years. We will have a doubt. 5 years means we should keep under non-current asset. No. Because FD, anytime you can close, no problem. Even though you made a 5 year deposit, can't you go and close tomorrow? Premature closure is there, na? So that is the reason bank thought government securities, quoted investment, fixed assets, even though period is more than that, you can classify under current assets. Any, like you are receiving advance. If you are giving any advance to somebody for purchasing of raw material, that is also current assets. Now, important point, prepaid expenses. Any prepaid expenses for the business purpose, if you make any expenses prepaid, that also will be classified under current asset. Any advances, taxes you have paid, that is also current assets. Okay. And other current assets, accrued investment, loans and advances, depending on the holdings. If the loans and advances for 1 year, it is a current. If you are getting the amount, if this, you have given loan advances. See, loans and advances you have given. If it is coming within 1 year, current asset. Okay. Intangible assets. This is very, very important. I told you, intangible assets, which you cannot see, goodwill, these, you know, goodwill, patents, accumulated losses, profit will come here, losses will come under intangible assets, even bad and doubtful assets, doubtful debts also called as intangible assets. Please remember, friends, this important line here, preliminary express and pre-operative expenses. These expenses company will do. Any company, whatever I'm talking, or more important points are company related. Preliminary expenses and pre-operative expenses means before the company started, they will do some expenses preliminarily that will be classified as intangible assets. Always there is a confusion. Please remember, even I confuse even today. Preliminary expenses, pre-operative expenses, and prepaid expenses. These names are always confusing. please remember, all are pre. Please remember, prepaid expenses is current asset. Preliminary and pre-operative, see, preliminary, before starting the company, expenses, pre-operative, operation, that business account, business not started operation, still have expended these two expenses. Any expenses you made before starting the business will be called as preliminary and pre-operative expenses. And these expenses will be classified as intangible assets. This is not an asset. This is not a current asset. This is not a fixed asset. It is called intangible assets. I made it black. Please remember, preliminary, pre-operative, but prepaid expenses classified under current assets. Okay. Last one, non-current assets. Current assets means within 12 months. Fixed assets means longer period. Intangible means, I told you, any expenses or accumulated losses, goodwill, all these things will come. Non-current assets means you have money you are investing which is not related to business. See, you are investing in subsidiaries. If you are taking finance or your margin, if you are putting in subsidiaries, it is a non-current assets. Any deferred receivables, any loans and advances, depending on the nature, if it is more than 1 year, here they are told holding, you see. If within 1 year, if you are receiving back your money, it is a current asset. If you are giving loan and advances for more than 1 year, it is a non-current assets. And unquoted investments and non-consumable stores and spares, these also will be classified under non-current assets. This is a typical company balance sheet. First time I tried, generally I don't tell company balance sheet, but for examination purpose, you have to remember liabilities are this side, assets are this side, capital will be there, term liabilities will be there, current liabilities. These are the sources. These are the long-term sources, capital and term. And this is a short-term source. Fixed assets are long-term use. And current assets are short-term use. This is also long-term use. Intangible assets. These are intangible assets. Okay. This is how you have to read the balance sheet. With this, I'm concluding my class. But how much time, I don't know. Now I want to tell you how to solve the problems by understanding the balance sheet. Now you understand what is a balance sheet. Now let us see some problems. It's 9 o'clock, but I'll continue my session because I have to correlate that balance sheet class with problems. So I prepared these questions for you. Even some MCQ also, I have taken some questions. First important thing is we will try to recollect the formulas I told you. How to get NWC, sir? Current assets minus current liability. I told you, if you remember my balance sheet class. Long and other formula is long-term source minus long-term use. These are the two ways you can clear NWC. Current ratio means current assets minus current assets divided by current liabilities. Then one more ratio, which I have not discussed during my class. Quick ratio. Sometimes they will ask. Nothing. It is just like current assets minus current liabilities only. Quick assets by current liabilities. Out of that current asset, one asset, they are telling it is not quickly realizable. That is stock. They are telling cash, it is already liquid. Bank balance, no problem. Debtors, okay, we will get recovery very fast. But they think that inventory, which is available in your business, they say it is not a quick asset. Inventory cannot be sold faster. That is the reason that will be removed from current asset and remaining assets will be quick asset. That's all. In layman language, quick asset means total current assets minus inventory. That's all. If they are asking current ratio, current assets minus current liability divided by current liability. If they are asking quick ratio, current assets minus current liabilities only one formula we do. From current assets, you remove inventory. That's all. Next, coming to debt equity. TOL, TNW, you have done total outside liabilities divided by tangible net worth. Okay. Debt equity means long-term debt. What is the long-term debt, sir? The long-term debt is your term loan. Debt, capital is not a debt. It is a long-term source. It is not a debt. Term loan is also long-term source, but it is a debt. You are taking finance from bank divided by tangible net worth. If it is a proprietorship firm, partnership firm, take capital only as tangible net worth, I'm telling you. If you are taking a company balance sheet, take capital and reserves and minus intangible assets, then you will arrive to tangible net worth. This is the formula for debt equity. Debt equity means long-term debt divided by tangible net worth. And the last important formula is DSCR. For scale 1 to 2, they may ask simple formula. 2 to 3 and 3 to 4, they will pose some question on DSCR. DSCR formula is 1 minute. Sir, class much longer. So DSCR, debt service coverage ratio. See, all these things we will assess under balance sheet. But DSCR, debt service coverage ratio, why we do this? Everybody, majority of the people, term loan they do. If you want to sanction a term loan and you want to know the repayment capacity of the borrower, the only formula available is DSCR for term loans. DSCR stands for debt means long-term debt, debt service coverage ratio. How fast the party can pay, how much income he is getting to pay back your loan amount, that part we will see. What is the formula for that? Please by heart this formula. Net profit after tax, that is, this is the total income he is getting. Net profit after tax, this also you remember, net profit, not before tax. Net profit after, that means net profit he is getting after tax, plus depreciation you have to add back. Depreciation generally we deduct, now again we have to add back. Okay, then interest on term loan, because we are talking about term loan DSCR. I told you what is the interest you are charging on the term loan, that also you have to take, divided by again interest on term loan will come, plus annual installment. What is the annual installment you are paying for that particular loan, term loan, that also you have to take. This is DSCR formula. Please by heart, you write this formula somewhere, because you are going to solve some questions now. Three questions I framed on this particular formula. Net profit after tax plus depreciation plus interest on term loan divided by interest on term loan plus annual installment. Okay, with this, now we are going to solve the questions. Scale 1 to 2, easy questions will come like this. Current assets is 20 lakhs. Current liability is 10 lakhs. What is the NWC and what is the current ratio? Okay, you know the formula, na? NWC means current assets minus current liabilities. Current ratio means current asset divided by current liabilities. They have given, only you should know the formula. This is the easiest sum. Now let us see. Problem is current assets 20, current ratio. Solution. Current assets minus current liabilities, NWC. So 20 is current assets, 10 is current liability. Answer is 10 lakhs. He want current ratio also. No problem. Current assets divided by current liabilities. 20 divided by 10. Current ratio is 2. This is the easiest sum. Maybe 1 to 2 you may get luckily. Now little bit critical we do. Little bit critical. Only NWC. See how many type of questions he poses with you. Stock is 20 lakhs. Creditors 10 lakhs, debtors 5 lakhs, bank OCC 10 lakhs, provisions 2 lakhs. That means here he has not bifurcated. He has not given a banana to you. He has not told what is current asset, what is current liability. You have to bifurcate these items under current assets and current liabilities. Then you have to minus current asset minus current liability. That's all. Now we will do that. This is the problem. Solution. Out of this, we will try to bifurcate. We want current, we have to calculate NWC. For calculating NWC, we want current assets and current liabilities, right? So current asset, stock. Stock is a current asset? Yes. Asset side, stock, I told you, current assets. I have took stock. Stock is 20, I have taken. Creditors, I told you, it is a current liability. We have taken finance, we have to pay back. So creditor, I have taken here, 10 lakhs. Debtor, I have given the amount. It is a receivable to me. It is a current asset. So this is called debtors, will be called as book debts also. Okay. It is 5 lakhs. Bank OCC. It's a current liability. Current liability, I will put bank OCC. 10 lakhs. Provisions. I told you all the provisions will be current liabilities. So 2 lakhs. This is also current liability. Now total it. You have to bifurcate the figures. 1 to 2, this much simple question they may not ask. This type of question they will ask. So if you know what is a current asset, what is a current liability, you can answer. What are the current assets? I told you, stock, bank balance, cash, inventory, book debts, bills receivable, or current assets. Go to current liabilities. What are the current liabilities? Bank OCC. Within 1 year, you are paying. And provisions and your creditors. Those are the, all these things are available here. Just you have to bifurcate. That means examiner wants to check whether you know current assets and current liabilities. Formula anyway, you know, if you could able to bifurcate, you can get the answer. So 20 plus 5, 25 lakhs is current assets. Current liabilities are 10 plus 10 plus 2, 22. So now NWC is current assets minus current liabilities. We will 25 minus 22. NWC is 3 lakhs. Over. So next question. Current assets are 50,000. Net working capital is 50,000. What is the current liability? Now he wants to ask you, NWC has given, current asset he has given. He is asking current liability. If you know the formula, it is an easy question. See, current assets are 50,000. Net working capital 50,000. I have written my formula. Current assets minus current liabilities, NWC. I got current asset 50,000. He has given, he is asking me current liabilities minus current liability is equal to NWC is 15,000. If I want current liabilities, 50,000 minus 15,000, 35,000 is the answer. So current liability is 35,000. That's all. It's a scale 1 to 2 question again. Now one more question. This is a little bit tougher. I can expect for 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. NX Limited is having a current assets twice that of current liabilities. You, whenever this type of question comes, write a balance sheet. Write a balance sheet. Current liabilities, current asset. Assets, this said, liabilities. What they're telling, NW is 55,000. NW is networking. Current assets minus current liabilities, NWC. They have given NWC to you, but they are not revealing what is current asset and what is current liabilities. And they are telling a clue to you. Current assets are twice that of current liabilities. That means if current liability is 1 rupee, current asset is 1 into 2, 2 rupees. This is what he is telling. Now we will find out the solution. Okay, what he told? He is telling current minus current liabilities, NWC. NWC has given 55,000, no problem. But he is not revealing the figures here. But he has given a clue to me. Current assets are twice that of current liability. That means if current liability is 1 rupee, this is 2 into 1. So I have taken current liability as X. Okay, current liability as X, but current assets are twice that of current liability. That means 2 into current liability. So 2X minus X, I will write, correct? Current liability is X, but current assets is 2X because current assets are twice. Twice means double. X, 2X is current assets. So 2X minus X is equal to 55,000. Then 1X is equal to 55,000. So X is equal to 55,000. If I put X place, current liability place, 55,000, what will be here? 2 into 55,000 is current assets. That means 1,10,000. Okay? 1,10,000 is current liability and 55, sorry, current asset. 55,000 is my current liability. My NWC is 55,000. So he has given this figure and he is asking me to calculate this figure. I have calculated. Because of this clue, I could able to do this. Okay? Coming to next question. Total assets are 20. Current liabilities are 10 lakhs. Capital and reserves are 4 lakhs. How much is debt equity ratio? First, you must understand what is the debt equity formula. Debt equity formula is long-term debt divided by tangible net worth. Okay. Now we will see what is the answer for this. Same question I'm repeating here. I have written. This is the question. Now what I will do is, I will prepare a small balance sheet in my rough sheet in the examination hall. Liabilities I will write, assets I will write, capital, term loan, current liabilities, right? I have written only 3 items. Here, fixed assets, intangible assets, current assets, non-current assets also will be there because it's a small account. I have written this much. Now I will start putting the figures. He has given total assets to me. I will put total assets 20. If this is total is 20, automatic liability also 20. So 2 things I got. Now I will see. Current liability, he told 10 lakhs. Very good. Current liability, I will put 10 lakhs here. Capital and reserve is 4 lakhs. Very good. Capital, I will write 4 lakhs. So these 2 columns I have filled already. This total is 20. So what will be the term loan, sir? Automatically, if this total is 20, He has given current liability as 10 lakh and capital as 4 lakh. 10 plus 4 is 14, minus 20, 6 lakhs is term loan. So I got my term loan. That means if you know the formula also, long-term debt means term loan. But he is not giving directly long-term debt to you. He wants to check your knowledge with regard to balance sheet. So that is the reason he has given the figures. Okay. So 20 lakhs he has given total. So I will approach here also liability for 20. Out of that liability, they have given current liability 10 lakhs. I got the information. Capital I got 4. So total 14 lakhs he has given information. In between, I kept term loan for ready. I will minus the figure 10 plus 14 minus 20. 6 lakhs I will get. Now I got the term loan. Now I can calculate. What is the formula? Long-term debt by equity or tangible net worth. What is the long-term debt, sir? Term loan, 6 lakhs. 6 is the long-term. Equity is, here there is no intangible assets. So I will take total capital as equity. 6 minus 4, answer is 1.5, over. But if you doesn't know how to prepare this balance sheet, you cannot answer the question. That's why I told that much of time to make you understand what is a balance sheet. Now, one more question. Question will be typical, but if you prepare a balance sheet, it will be easy. Total assets are 20 lakhs. Net worth is 3 lakhs. Debt equity ratio is 3:1. How much is the current ratio? If fixed asset is 8 lakh. You see how much easily we can answer. Again, we will prepare our own balance sheet. Liabilities, assets, I will put. Capital, term loan, current liability, I will put. Fixed assets, intangible asset, current asset, I will put. Now, I will start preparing my balance sheet. Total assets, 20. No problem. Assets are 20 means liability also 20. These two answers I got. Now I will go to net worth. Net worth is nothing but your capital. So 3 lakhs. I will write here 3 lakhs. This also I got answer. Debt equity ratio. I will keep it for some time. How much is the current ratio? If fixed asset is 8 lakh. That means fixed asset also he has given to me. 8 lakhs I will put. So 8 lakhs I got fixed assets. That means 20 is the total assets. Automatically current asset is 12 lakh. So I got current assets also. If current asset is 12, this figure I got 8 lakhs from here, 20 total they have given. I deducted 20 minus 8 and I have arrived at current assets. So assets tallied. Liability side, 20 I have given. Capital he has given 3 rupees I have taken. But he has not given debt equity. He is telling debt equity ratio is 3:1. If debt equity is 3:1 means what is the meaning, sir? Debt equity, long-term debt by equity. So that means capital is 1 rupee means how much he can borrow from you debt? 9 rupees, correct? 3:1, I told you. If it is 1 rupee, this is 3 rupees means he has given this amount, capital. I have took this. Now I am arriving term loan by debt equity ratio. When he said debt equity is 3:1, if 1 rupee he brings, 3 rupees he can borrow as a term loan, long-term debt, term loan. So 1 rupee means here 3 rupees means 3 into 3, 9 rupees. So term loan, I got 9 rupees. This is how I have arrived at these 9 rupees. I hope I am clear. This is very, very important. He has given debt equity, but he has not given how much term loan it is. But he told capital how much. So I took capital here 3. Capital means this is 1. Now I want 3. If it is 1 is 3 rupees, how much will be 3? 3 into 3, it is 9 rupees. Now 3 and 9 are 12 rupees. If I deduct this 12 rupees from 20, I will get current liability automatically. 8 rupees. Now my balance sheet is tallied. Now what is the solution for this? What they have asked in this? How much is the current ratio? How much is the current ratio now? 12 divided by 8. You will get your current ratio. He is asking how much is the current ratio? 12 divided by 8. That means in the examiner, what he thought is he will give you a clue of capital. He asked you to arrive term loan. After this, if you add this and minus total liabilities, you will get current liability. Then only you can give the formula 12 minus 8 and you will arrive your current ratio. Now one more problem. Total liabilities are 10 lakhs. Fixed assets are 4 lakhs. Non-current assets are 1 lakh. Which of the following statement is correct? Now we will again, we will write a timetable, one table, okay? Same, capital, term loan, current liabilities, fixed assets, intangible assets, non-current asset, current asset. Now let us see what he has given the in the exam, in the question paper. Total liabilities are 10 lakhs. Total liability 10 means automatically my assets also 10 lakhs. Okay, over. Fixed assets is 4 lakh. He has given this figure also. I have written. Non-current asset 1 lakh. I have given non-current asset 1 lakh. Now he is asking which of the following statement is correct. Now what you can arrive, sir? 4 he has given, 1 he has given. Here nothing he has given. Okay. Net worth is 4 lakhs. Capital he has not given. How to calculate? It is not possible. Leave it. Debt equity ratio is 1.4. Without capital and term loan, I cannot calculate debt equity ratio. Current ratio is less than 1. He has not given me current assets and current liabilities. I cannot. Current assets is 5. Whether I can calculate this, you see. Yes, I can calculate. Because he has told total assets are 10. Fixed assets are 4. He has given very clearly. Non-current assets also he has given 1. So what is the difference? The balance 5 lakhs is current assets. So this answer is correct. Current assets I can calculate from this data. This will be 5 because fixed assets and current assets I know. Total assets also I know. So I have deduct 4 plus 1, 5. 5 minus 10 is current assets. This is how you have to calculate. Now, one important, one little big problem. We have to bifurcate these figures. They have given the figures. Now we will make a balance sheet for these figures and we will understand. This is the last problem with regard to working capital ratios. Then I will tell DS here. Now he has mixed all the figures. Now you have to bifurcate these figures. After bifurcation, you have to calculate current ratio, quick ratio, debt total, debt equity ratio. Current ratio, you know the formula, but examiner is very intelligent. He has given all the figures. Now we have to prepare a small balance sheet with these expenses. Then only we can do current ratio, current assets divided by current liabilities, quick ratio, current asset minus inventory divided by current liabilities, debt equity ratio, long-term debt divided by tangible net worth. Tangible net worth means capital plus reserves minus intangible assets. Okay. We know the formulas now. Now let us, we will allocate these balance sheet items in seriatim. I have given capital, same everywhere I will write this balance sheet, capital, term loan, current liabilities, fixed assets, intangible assets, non-current assets, current assets. Okay. Now we will bifurcate. Capital and reserves are 24. Where it will go, sir? Here it will come. I have given 24. Trade creditors. I told you creditors is current liability. Creditors. We have to pay the amount. 12 rupees. Bank cash. OCC. Current liability. I will put bank OCC 20 lakhs here. Security for LCT. I will tell you last. Stock. Easy. Current asset. Current asset stock 30 lakhs. I kept here. Cash and bank balance. Within 12 months, it is liquidated. 6 lakhs current assets. Cash and bank balance 6 lakhs. Sales. It will not come under balance sheet. It is a trading account. Term loans. 16. Yes, it is a liability term loan. Term loan is a long-term debt. So 16 lakhs I kept here. Expenses payable. Expenses payable. I have to pay the amount. Expenses payable is a liability. It's a trade creditors. Expenses receivable is an asset. You are going to receive the amount. It's an asset for you. It is a liability. You have to make the payment. Expenses payable is 8 rupees. Preliminary expenses. See, this question always will confuse. I told you from the first itself. Preliminary expenses, pre-operative expenses are intangible assets. Prepaid expenses are current asset. Now, what is this? Preliminary. Before starting the company, they have expended. So it is an intangible assets. I kept the preliminary expenses as intangible assets. Book debts. Book debts. Book debts is a current asset. So I kept current asset, 14 lakhs. Net profit, not required for us. It is not a balance sheet item. Sales and net profit is not a balance sheet item. One item I left is security for electricity. The security for electricity is a non-current asset. It is not a current asset. So I have kept here. Now, if I total the balance sheet is tallied for me. Here, he has not tallied, but I have tallied. Now, we will see what are the questions he posed. The same figures I brought here to make you understand. The first question is current ratio. What is the current asset? 36 plus 14, 36, 40, 50. 50 is current asset. What is current liabilities? 20, 32, 8, 40. 50 minus 50 divided by 40, 1.25. One problem is over. If you doesn't allocate, you cannot answer any question here. Please remember. Next question, quick ratio. I told you, total current assets are already available, 50. From 50, what you have to deduct? Stock. 50 minus 30. Stock you have to stock is not a quick asset. Remaining all are quick assets, they told. So 50 minus 30, 20. Quick assets I got. Current liability, these three items, 40. 20 minus 40, 0.5 is quick ratio. Coming to debt equity ratio, long-term debt by tangible net worth. What is the long-term debt, sir? Term loan, 16. What about tangible net worth? Capital I can take, but before taking capital and reserves, I have to see whether any intangible assets are available. From capital, you have to remove intangible assets to reach your tangible net worth. 20, here it is there. That is the reason they have given preliminary expenses. 24 minus 2 is 22. So 22 is your tangible net worth. So 16 minus 20, 16 divided by 22, 0.73 is your debt equity ratio. So I have tried to maximize my questions so that you can understand. Three problems of DSCR I will tell you and I will finish my class for today. Formula, you know, this is a basic thing. Net profit after tax they will give, depreciation they will give, interest on term loan they will give, annual installment they will give, calculate DSCR. Only thing you should know is formula. Now we see the answer. DSCR calculation. This is the problem part. This is the problem they have given. I have written my formula, NPAT plus depreciation plus interest on term loan divided by interest on term loan annual. This, whenever a DSCR question comes, you have to write the formula first. Now we have an answer. NPAT 150, nothing. What to do? You can also do it. Depreciation 60, interest on term loan 40. Okay. Then interest on term loan again, I have to take 40. Annual installment he has given 85. Total it 250. Total it 125. DSCR is 2. Please remember, friends, if at all in the examiner asked, what is the benchmark for DSCR? DSCR benchmark is 1.5. What is meant by this 1.5 is DSCR 1.5 means party is having income of 1 rupee 50 paisa to clear your 1 rupee due. That is what 1.5 means. If he's got 1 means he has got 1 rupee income to pay your 1 rupee liability. DSCR 1 means equal. 1.5 means he is having 50% extra income. 1 rupee he will pay it to you. Other than that, 0.50% of income is more in his pocket. That means he has to pay 1 rupee, but his income is 1 rupee 50 paisa. That is what this definition we should understand. Coming to second problem on DSCR. This is little bit tougher. They will not give NPAT here. Net profit after tax they will not give. They will give you net profit before tax and they will give you tax and remaining all is same. Now we will answer this question. Net profit before tax they have given, tax they have given. So you have to calculate net profit after tax. Formula is this. Every time I will write my formula. Now, because I want net profit after tax, I cannot take net profit before tax. I will deduct 200 minus 50. Net before tax is 200, tax is 50. 150 is net profit after tax. Once this is calculated, again formula. 150, 100 rupees depreciation, interest on term loan 50, and interest on term loan again 50, annual installment is 120. So total of this is 300, total of this is 170, and 1.76 is the DSCR. That means 76 paisa extra he is having after 1 rupee of your repayment also. This is better than 1.5. DSCR improvisation means party is having more repayment capacity. Okay. Last problem for today. This is a tickling question. This is a tickling question. Please read the question. Net profit after tax is 200. Tax is 50. Depreciation 100. Interest on term loan is 50. Annual installment is 120. Calculate DSCR. Just examiner wants you to make some mistake. Whenever you see tax means net profit before tax comes, now we will deduct. No. Same question. net profit after tax 200, tax 50, everything you have given. Only problem is you should not deduct tax. You should ignore this. This is the logic of this question. He has given already net profit after tax. It is not net profit before tax. Why I am telling is, so many times IBPS asks this question only. They will give NPAT, again they will give tax. That means if a person doesn't know, he will deduct tax. And his problem answer will be there for that. So he will tick it and he will go. So NPAT is, it is already tax is deducted. So you need not do, you just ignore this tax. This is the logic here. Okay. So 200 you take here straight away, 50 rupees you ignore, depreciation take 100, interest on term loan you take 50. Again, interest on term loan 50 you take, annual installment you take 120, you will get the DSCR 2.06, which is better than other ratio. I think one more question is there. Okay, I will answer this question also. This is a little bit tough question. This came in CCP exam, Certified Credit Professional exam. So this is the last question for today's class. As on 31st March 2019, for 3 to 4 people, they can listen to this. The liability they have given 1500 lakhs. Medium and long-term liabilities are 300 lakhs. Current assets are 1000 lakhs. Pre-operative expenses are 50 lakhs. Current ratio is 2:1. What is the tangible net worth? Simple. Now again, we will write the balance sheet. No problem. What they have given, sir? Total liabilities are 1500. Yes, I will put 1500 here first. Assets also I will give 1500. Totals I got. Medium and long term liability 300. That means he is telling term loan is 300. Okay. Term loan column I will go. I will put 300. Over. Current assets 1000. Okay. He has given current assets to me. Current assets also I will keep. Okay. Then pre-operative expenses are 50 lakhs. I told you again and again. Pre-operative expenses, preliminary expenses are intangible assets. Again and again I am repeating. Prepaid expenses are current asset. This is a pre-operative. Pre-operation, before operation expenses. I told you, it's an intangible assets. So intangible assets, I will make this 50 lakhs. Now what he told, if the current ratio is 2:1, if current ratio is 2:1, what is the meaning, sir? Current assets are 2 means current liabilities are 1. Correct? So current liabilities 1000 means 1000 divided by 2 if I make, I will get my current liabilities. So 500. So current ratio 2:1 means 1000 minus 500. 1000 divided by 500 if I put, I am getting this 2. That means I have rightly written. So this they have given 1000. They have not given current liabilities, but they have given the ratio. With this ratio, I calculated this. Because it is a 2:1. If this is 2, this is 1. So automatically if it is 2 means 50% is 1. So 500. Over. So current liability I got because of current asset. Term loan they have given, but they have not given the capital to me. Because I got the total liability. Total liability is 1500. I got current liability and term loan. Total is 800. If I deduct this 800 from 1500, I will get my capital. So you have to get capital here. Number. This is the question. He doesn't want to give directly capital. He will give all the figures and he will ask you to calculate. Total liability he has given, term loan he has given, current liability he has not given, but he has given current asset and told the ratio to calculate current liability. I have calculated that also. After calculating this 800, I minus it with 1500 and I got capital of 700. My balance sheet is tallied. Here also it is 1050 they have given. Remaining figures they have not given. No problem. Why? Because what is the question? What is the tangible net worth? Tangible net worth, I told you the formula is capital is net worth only, reserves. But if there is any intangible assets, these things to be deducted. So 700 is total net worth minus 50. It is 650 is your tangible net worth. Thank you, friends. I finished my class. I hope balance sheet, any question if comes, probably you people could able to answer. Sir.
Thank you. Yes, sir.